Hello everyone, this is Ashwin. How is it going on? Welcome back to my series of tutorials on OpenCV and Python 3. Till now we have learned a lot of OpenCV and Python. We have actually gotten started with webcam handling. Till now we have learned how to capture a still image from webcam, how to render it using OpenCV's internal imshow function, as well as how to render it on the screen with matplotlib, okay, pyplot. Pyplot package in the matplotlib to be very precise. And then we also saw how to process a live video stream. And in the last video, we saw how to record a live video stream using a webcam, Python and OpenCV 3. So now in this video, we are going to see how to playback any video file. So we are going to write our own small utility for playing back a video file. Just make sure that you have some video file for playing back. Okay, otherwise this program is not gonna work. So this is the last program that we saw which saves the live video feed from a webcam with Python and OpenCV 3 into a video file. Okay, so let me delete the last output and let me record this the output of this program again. Yeah, so this is my hand, talk to my hand. That is the dialogue from movie Terminator, and it is said by, I guess, Arnold Schwarzenegger, a very popular actor, one of my favorites. So let us play back the video file. Yeah, this is the talk to my hand dialogue. Now we are going to make the modifications in the same program in order to play back the video file. So let us delete some part first, and then yeah. So first of all, we are going to copy this line from here to here, and let me tell you, explain you why we are going to do this, why we are doing this. And OpenCV media player. So this is not actually media player, it is only a video player, because I am not programmatically capturing the audio. And even if you use some other file for which has got actually embedded audio in that for playing back, I don't think that it is going to play the audio back, because we do not have any provision in the code to play back the audio, right, to access the speaker and all. That is a whole different library that comes under audio processing, and as of now that is not in the scope of this tutorial series. So just copy this file name and pass it to the video capture function. Now this video capture function we earlier used to capture the live video feed from a webcam and to capture the still frames from the webcam, but here it is going to capture the frames from a video file. Okay, so remember, it can be used in both the ways. It can be used to capture the frames from a live webcam, or it can be used to capture the video frames from a video file. So let's copy this thing. If cap is opened, okay, while cap is opened, we can say, or we can just say while true, while ret, okay, and let's set the ret to true. Okay, so this is initial value, that's why we have to set it true, because ret is going to return us next time. Okay, so let's say if cap is opened, then read ret and frame. Okay, and as long as we have the value of ret is true, if ret, then cv2.imshow. Okay, else break. Okay, so this is the simple code. So as long as ret is going to be true, this is going to check if the cap is open, I mean if the file is open, and if the file is open, then it is going to read a frame from the file. It is going to store that frame in the variable which is also coincidentally named as frame, and ret is the value like which is going to be true if we are able to successfully read a frame. I mean, if the cap.read is success, then ret is going to be true. If the cap.read is failed, then ret is going to be false. So in order to debug, we can just say print ret, and if the ret is true, then we are going to render that frame on the screen. If red is false, then we are just going to break. And once we break, we are going to destroy all the windows, and we are also going to release the video file that we are reading. So let's clear the console. This is the video file, right? And let's run this code. I have already jotted down the code in some other this thing. So it says while cap is opened, okay. So I don't think it is gonna work. Is it gonna work? So let's copy this here, like while cap is opened. And okay, so let's run it this way, print red, and then we don't have to set the red equal to true here. So let us see like this logic, like if the cap is open, I mean whenever if the file is open, as long as the file is open, we are going to read the frame from the file, then we are going to print the value of red, and when RET is, as long as RET is true, it is going to render the variable on screen. If RET is false, then we are going to break the complete execution of this while loop, and then we are going to destroy the windows and all the windows, and then we are going to release the video file that we are reading. So this is the video file once again to see. Talk to my hand, and let's execute the code. Yeah, this runs, this seems to be working perfectly fine, right? So as soon as I execute the code, and as long as the value is of the red is true, it just actually plays the video back. You must have observed one thing, one particular thing, that the video playback is too fast. This is because the value that we have passed, the argument that we have passed here in wait key. So if you remember, we are recording this video with the frame rate of 30 FPS. Okay, so this is the earlier program which I have used to record this video, and the frame rate here is 30 FPS. Okay, so now we need to actually get into a bit of maths. So the frame rate is 30 FPS. Okay, in order to enable a very smooth video playback, we need to make sure that 30 frames, even the playback rate is actually 30 FPS. Okay, 30 FPS is video capture rate. Okay, video capture rate. Now even the playback rate has to be 30 FPS. So 30 FPS playback rate, it means that see this cv2.wait key, the argument that we pass to this function is in milliseconds, and we also know that 1000 millisecond is 1 second, if I'm not wrong. Okay, so we need to play back 30 FPS, 30 frames in 1000 milliseconds. Now what we are doing is like we are playing all these 30 frames in 30 milliseconds, because here the millisecond is only one, right? So if the millisecond is one, we are actually playing back all the 30 frames in 30 milliseconds, right? Milliseconds. So all we have to do is we need to make sure that this is we have to pass an appropriate argument to cv2.wait key. So we can actually calculate the value of that argument by dividing 1000 by video capture FPS, video capture FPS. So as of now, 1000 divided by 33. So sorry, 1000 divided by 30, it's almost equal to 33 point something, right? 33. So that delay that we have to give is almost 33. Okay, now we are going to see the playback with the correct speed, because see 30, now this way it is going to render a frame from the video file every 33 milliseconds. Okay, so for every 33 milliseconds, it is going to read and render the frame. So for 1 second, it is rendering 30 frames, correct? So because 30 into 33 equal almost equal to 30 into 33 is almost equal to 1000, right? It's equal to 1000, but we can't actually get the correct value because point and all is not permissible, I guess. Decimal point is not permissible. So let us play back the video. Yes, Now you can see the correct speed. If you want to slow down this video, then you can even like add more delay, correct? So just if you want to run it by at half speed, then you can just say 66. See, it is running at half speed. Or you wanna just say 33 into 4 happens to be almost 130, right? This is the quarter of the speed. So if you have got a really high speed camera, okay, so something like Canon's camera, like RX100 Mark 5, right? It is capable of capturing 1000 frames per second. So in that case, you can just say CV2.wait key is 1, and you will be able to see a nice and uninterrupted slow motion. So this program you can even use for creating the slow motion effect if you have sufficiently high speed camera. Okay, to possess a sufficiently high speed camera is the prime requirement for this, because the shutter speed of the normal cameras, okay, shutter speed of the normal cameras while recording the videos is going to be like very less, so that the high speed cameras will have like very high shutter speed. It is able to capture like 1000 images per second, right? 1000 frames per second. Then playing back 1000 frames per second or playing back a single frame per second is not going to be a problem, that big problem. Or even if you play back it at the normal video speed, okay, 33 or something like that, even that 1000 frame per second video, you are going to get a very nice and smooth slow motion video, which you can use for editing your like film or whatever you are making. So this is the normal speed once again. And if you want to see the double speed, just say 17, because 33 divided by 2 almost equals to 16 or 17, right? 16 into 2 is 32 and 17 into 2 is like 34. Yeah, this is the double speed. So this is how we can create a small media player. Now we are all comfortable with the trackbar stuff, right? We can use the trackbar now to adjust the video speed. You can just try to use trackbar to adjust the video speed. This is how we can play a video back using OpenCV3 and Python 3. You can replace this video file with any of the video file. You can just try to play a movie file, and it is going to play the video component very well. So let me know if I can make any, let me know your thoughts and suggestions on improving this particular program. If you have got any ideas how we can make this program more efficient, or we can add some more things to this, all these comments and suggestions are welcome. Just like make sure that you write all these things in the comments and suggestions section down below. Thanks a lot for watching my video. Let me know your thoughts and suggestions in the comment section. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. I will see you next time.